we have the gluteal muscle, it's large. Pain can appear along the leg on the lateral surface. When a person sits over time, this muscle can shorten. Now our task is to activate the gluteus maximus muscle. Hello everyone, friends. My name is Maxim Mamshur. I am a physical therapist and I am also the co-founder of a network of physical therapy centers called Healthy Movement. Friends, today we are going to talk about a rather interesting topic, sciatic nerve inflammation, also known as sciatica. Here is where the sciatic nerve is located. And today I will explain to you what it's all about, why pain appears there, how this pain spreads, and most importantly, I will tell you how to get rid of it. So make sure to watch this video until the end. Save these exercises for yourself and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. Let's get started. Let's quickly go over the biomechanics. What happens and why this pain occurs? Let me explain. Look, friends, we have the gluteal muscle. It's a large muscle. During walking, our gluteal muscle actively works as follows. It effectively moves the leg backward. Basically, every single day when we take steps, when we walk, our leg moves backward thanks to the powerful gluteus maximus muscle. If it isn't strong enough or doesn't move our leg backward effectively enough, and by the way, I'll explain later why this actually happens, the gluteus medius and also the piriformis muscle start to significantly help it. They become quite overstrained because this isn't really their primary job, and they then compress the sciatic nerve. As a direct result, we may experience pain along the entire leg on the lateral surface, and even the proper function and smooth movement of the foot itself can significantly worsen. Why might the gluteus maximus not function properly? Let me explain. It may not effectively perform the backward movement of the leg because we also have the powerful iliopsoas muscle. And when, for example, a person spends a significant amount of time sitting in an office chair or behind the steering wheel of a vehicle, the iliopsoas muscle tends to shorten, primarily because its attachment points are located at the lower part of the spine. It then passes through the hip joint and ultimately attaches to the femur. Accordingly, when a person sits, over time this muscle can become shortened. Its primary function during normal walking is to effectively bring the leg forward. Accordingly, if this particular muscle, by the way, we can clearly see now how this muscle has significantly shortened. If it is indeed shortened physically during the act of walking, we simply cannot move the leg back properly and efficiently using the powerful gluteal muscles. And as a result, over time, the gluteal muscle starts to function poorly, the piriformis and the gluteus medius take over the load, compress the sciatic nerve, and pain appears. Don't switch channels, please stay with us, and we will learn some effective exercises that will certainly help to relieve this uncomfortable flare-up. The first exercise is stretching the iliopsoas muscle. We get into this position. The left leg is in front, the right leg is bent at the knee. And as you exhale, lean forward. Return to the starting position. Work within your own range of motion. One, starting position. Two, you can add an exhale to make it easier. One, starting position. Three, starting position. Four, five. Now, do the same on the other leg. Next, exercise number two, then simply lie down completely on your back. Now, our task is to activate the gluteus maximus muscle so that it takes over the load from the gluteus medius and piriformis muscles. Cross one leg over the other while lying on your back. Lift your hips up, tightening the right glute on the leg that you are lifting with. On the exhale, time, two, three, we shorten the buttock upwards, four, five, six, it is very important not to overextend the lumbar region, seven, eight, nine, finished, and we do the same thing 10 to 15 times on the other leg, and then we move on to the third exercise. Foot over foot and press your hand on your knee. One, starting position. Two, starting position. If there is pain, we work within a small range of motion. Each time, try to increase the range of motion a little. Similarly, with each workout, try to increase the range of motion. Five, do the same with the other leg. If this number of repetitions is not enough, you can do each exercise for 2 to 3 sets. Friends, I really hope that this set of exercises will help you get rid of the pain running down your leg. If you truly like this video, be sure to give it a definite like. Subscribe to our fantastic channel, because every single week we consistently release brand new episodes about persistent pain in our spine, neck, lower back, knees, and even our hip joints. So please subscribe now, and we will see you very soon.